Okay, I'm on page 35. Hopefully I gave out the workbook, so let's make sure we have that. Put your name in it and ink, and those textbooks I want you to keep at home. And remember, you're responsible for them. There's two of them up in the classroom here, and there's no name in them. So if you do not have your math book, you need to find out if these are yours. Anyhow, let's take a look here. It says, if then statements cause and effect. So, if water is heated, then it boils. Well, not necessarily. It doesn't always have to boil if you heat it up, okay? Now, if you get it to a certain temperature, 212 degrees, I guess it would boil, okay? So, here it says write some if-then statements on your own. Can you think of an if-then statement on your own? So, write something right now and think of something. So, I would say, if it rains, then I will not go. Because if it's raining, I just soon stay inside. Okay? So that would be an if-then statement right there. All right. Let's go to the next page here. I'm on page 36 right now. And I want you to try this one up here. We're going to try it together, as a matter of fact. So let's take a look. If a triangle, it says, write each statement as a conditional. So that means if something, then something. If, then. So if a triangle has all angles congruent. So if a triangle has all angles congruent or equal, then it is an equilateral triangle. So then, equilateral triangle. Well, that's true. So if you take a triangle, if this angle is equal to this one and it's equal to this one, then it's called an equilateral triangle. So that is a true statement. Okay? So the next one, you want to write it as an if-then statement. So if Alberto can go to the movies, then. Oh, it says, now this is switched up. Okay, see how it says, if he washes the car? If he washes the car? That's your beginning right there. So if Alberto washes the car, then he can go to the movies. Be careful on that one. That one's kind of tricky. They put the if part in the back. So I'm pretty sure this is going to come first. So if Alberto washes the car, then he can go to the movies. So copy that down so you know. The next one says find the truth value. If a quadrilateral has a right angle, then it is a rectangle. Well, that could be. A quadrilateral is a four-sided figure. So if it has a right angle, it could be a rectangle, but it could also be a square. So the truth value would be sometimes. If X is the midpoint of AB, so draw a segment AB and put X as a midpoint and then make that equal to that. X lies on AB. That would be true. If it's a midpoint, it's got to be on segment AB. So that would be true. So this one is sometimes, this one is always. Okay? And that's what you're doing there. So if a polygon is a quadrilateral, then it has four sides. That's true. A quadrilateral has a four-sided figure, but they want you to write, let's see. Write and determine the truth value of the converse. So they want you to switch this and then determine if it's true. So if a figure has four sides, then it is a quadrilateral. Now, is that true? Well, if it has four sides, it would be a quadrilateral. Okay. Now you might say, well, what if it's not open? Like here, 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 here. Okay, we're not going to go there. If it has four sides, it is a quadrilateral. Okay, that's what we're doing there. Let's try one more, and then I'll get you started on your work. It says write the converse, the inverse, and the contrapositive. So converse is switch, inverse is opposite. And contrapositive is switch, and opposite. Write that down. So if, circle that, and then this is your hypothesis, one line, and this is your conclusion, two lines. So if today is a weekend day, then tomorrow is Monday. Well, what if it's Saturday? Then it's going to be Sunday. So that's sometimes true. Okay. So the converse would be, they want the truth value too. Okay. So the converse, you're going to switch. So you're going to say, if tomorrow is Monday, if tomorrow is Monday, then today is a weekend day. Weekend day. And that would be true. Okay. Even if it's Sunday, it's still a weekend day. So that one would be true. Always. And then the inverse would be the opposite. So don't switch it. Just say, if today is not a weekend day. So the inverse would be, if today is not a weekend day. And I'm abbreviating here. Okay. I don't want you to abbreviate, but I am. So if today is not a weekend day, then tomorrow is not Monday. That's going to be true. If it's not a weekend day, then tomorrow is not Monday. That's going to be true. And then the contrapositive would be switch and opposite. So if tomorrow is not Monday, so if not Monday, then today is not a weekend day. A weekend day. Okay? Now you got to write them out, but let's take a look at that. So if today is not Monday, then today is not a weekend day. If tomorrow is not Monday, then today is not a weekend day. I'm going to say true on that. Okay, so that's what you're doing. What I want you to do, since you have your workbook, I want you to start on page 38, and I want you to do the odds. So 1.5, page 38, the odd. And since you have a workbook, you don't have to copy the problems. All right. What I do want you to do is bring your workbook every day, or actually that's what I want you to do. Bring your workbook every day, because we're going to be working in it, okay? All right, have a good morning.